Have you ever used wire printing in Cura? It's an experimental feature and produces some really interesting results. It looks like I used a 3D pen to produce this, but I didn't. I did this on a 3D printer. I'm going to try out several different printers and show you how this works on today's Filament Friday. This episode of Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. To try out this wire printing, I'm going to use this Spider-Man bust that I found on Thingiverse by user Berlin Rocks. So I wanted to test the print first, and this is the print at 75% of the original size. So I downsized it a little bit, and I printed this on my CR10S Pro. Now, I gave this a week review when I first reviewed it, and it was mainly because of the auto level. But I've since put on an actual build tag sheet that build tag told me to try, and it works great. And then I lowered the sensor to just 2 millimeters off the top of the bed, just adjusted the screws and lowered it like a lot of people suggested, and man, what a difference. I'm getting a lot more consistent first layer, and it sticks still a little bit too much, so I need to tweak it from time to time, but overall it's been pretty consistent. And the print quality, I've been getting great print quality off this. In fact, this is at a 0.28 layer height using my profiles, and it's as good a quality as I get at 0.2 on my CR10. Now this is like $200 more, but it runs quieter with the TMC drivers, and the print quality is really good. So once you get that auto level fixed and working right, it's definitely a really good printer. So I'm changing my tune on this guy a little bit. Here's a close up of the print. It's not perfect by any means, but 0.28 layer height, this is a pretty good print. I'm really happy with the results I'm getting here. But now I have my basis. Let me show you how to use the wire printing to print the same model on your printer. Here's the model loaded into Cura 4.0 on my Mac. I'm using the Creality CR10S Pro machine settings and my Magic Zero 0.28 profile. 0.28 layer height, 0.4 line width, 5% infill, 205 degrees, and I'm using my Filament Friday Filament Red. When that's sliced, it says it takes just over 5 hours to print. It took more like 6. Now, wire printing is down here under experimental. If you don't see it, click on the gear, and in the search, type wire. Then you'll see wire printing. Check that box, hit close, and wire printing should show up under the experimental menu. To wire print, just check the box and reslice. Now you notice it takes a lot less time. 2 hours and 2 minutes is what it says. Roughly half or maybe a third of the time. But you can't preview it. The preview doesn't work with the wire printing. Now instead of printing this on the CR10S Pro, because it was actually printing the bust when I did this, I printed it on my CR10 Mini, and I got a good camera angle of how this works, so let me show you it. So how this works, and this guy's about two-thirds done, is there's sections that are popped up, like Z-hopped, and then once those are all in place, it draws a line connecting all of them, kind of creating the top of the layer. And then once it finishes that, it'll stop and start the Z-hop motion to make the next layer of wireframe. So here it's just about done, and once it hits the end point, now it starts making the next layer. It goes up and down and makes these triangular or sawtooth type build area. It goes up and down and up and down. Now if you've got a sensor like the CR10S Pro had, occasionally it would hit the print. Now it wasn't hitting hard enough to knock anything off, but it was hitting it, where the CR10 Mini here was clearing pretty well. And some of these just don't exactly stick perfect, and some of them do. So it's really a variability, and that's what gives it that look like it was made with a 3D pen. So let me show you a close-up of this thing in action. Here it is finishing that layer that's connecting all the triangles, and now it's going to start a new one. And it goes back and then forward. It's really interesting how it does it. And then from there it starts to go straight up and then out. Up and then out. And you can see that some of them stick really well and some of them not quite. So I might have needed to raise the temperature just a little bit, but it seems to be working well. Now I believe you need a fan. The fan is blowing on this and that helps the filament stay in place. And a better fan than what the CR10 has may help, because you can see there's one that didn't really stay in place. So that's where you start to get flaws in the print. So you might be able to do a better job if you have better cooling. But this is really interesting to just watch how it does this. And I wouldn't want to do this by hand, so let the printer do it. Here's the same bust, but at 50%. So it only took an hour to print these guys, but I did it on Ender 3, Ender 3 Pro, and CR10S Pro. Each one printed with some flaws, but overall, pretty good results. Removing it from the bed actually became the trickiest part of this whole print. Now this one's on the CR10 Mini. This is the one I just showed the close-up of. And I used my painter's knife. It's part of my Filament Friday toolkit. We'll have more of these very, very soon, the toolkits. But I was able to slide it under and just slowly release this thing. And it's very fragile bottom. And I'll show you in a minute why the other printer didn't quite work as well as this. Glass really worked well. But then I could remove it and grab this thing, and it was surprisingly strong. I mean, you could crush this, but it's pretty solid in how this is put together. So I'm really impressed with how good this turned out, and this is the 75% size. This is actually the first one I printed on the Ender 3, and I had the bed a little bit too close. I was printing something else and had really tightened the bed down. So the spacing was a little too tight, and when I tried to pull it off, it pulled apart. So I had the bed way too close, but it showed me how critical it was to get the bed just right for this type of printing. Now I tried to use a raft in Cura to give me a nice solid base, but wire printing seemed to just ignore that setting. So I had to readjust the bed, and then I switched. I was running out of white. These are all Filament Friday filament colors. So I printed one on the Pro and one on the Ender 3 regular. And the regular, I still didn't have the bed right, but it was better. The Pro, I had that one adjusted perfect, and this thing is smooth. It came right off. And these are both really good prints. This red one came off the CR10S Pro, and it's the same 50% size as the ones that are on the Ender 3. But this one is definitely a little more fragile than those black ones. And it even can separate here at the bottom, and I can squish the head a little more. And the difference is a setting in Cura. What I tried once I started playing with these, I wanted to try a different line extrusion or extrusion width and see if that would work with the experimental wire printing and see if it would make this stronger. So let me explain what I did there. Before I explain that, here's the two black ones from the Ender 3 and Ender 3 Pro, and then the red one from the CR10S Pro. Those are all 50%. This one is 75% that was printed on the CR10 Mini. Up close like this, you really don't get the effect if you stand back and look at it, but I want you to see up close how this thing looks. It's interesting, kind of a zigzag puzzle. It almost looks handmade, but it's not. It's printed by the machine. But now let me explain the extrusion width and how it affects strength. I have two prints here. One is the red that was on the CR10 Pro, and here's a black one that was actually printed on the Ender 3. And notice I can squeeze the red one more than I can squeeze the black one. Here's the difference. So here's the bust at 50% inside Cura. Everything else is pretty much the same, the wire printing. 0.28 layer height, 0.4 layer width, and then, like I said, wire printing. And then when I sliced it, it took 1 hour and 1 minute was the estimate. And this is how I printed the red one. Then I went back on the black one and I changed the line width or extrusion width to 0.6. So it's going to extrude more plastic. I sliced it again. It said it would take the same amount of time, which was kind of strange. But look what happened. 0.34 millimeters is the width on the red one, and 0.54 is on the black one. So it worked in Cura. It did add some extrusion. And that's why the red one is easier to squeeze, and the black one is a little bit stiffer. I ended up printing two of these, one on the Ender 3 and one on the Ender 3 Pro. And in both cases, I used the same extrusion width of 0.6, and they're both a lot stronger. I did use the 0.4 on this 75% size on the CR10 Mini, printed really good, but it's definitely not as strong as those black ones. So I think that extrusion width actually helps. Even though I couldn't do a RAF, it did accept the higher extrusion width, at least it appears that it did, and made the print stronger. So I think the next step maybe is to try this out with a larger nozzle. And the perfect printer to probably do that on is my Artemis back here, because it prints really big, and it's already got a bigger nozzle. It's got a 0.5. And see if I can do the extrusion trick and get that bigger. I can even put a 0.8 on that thing real easy, and it prints a lot faster. And that's the beauty of this too, is it prints so much faster than a solid model, but they're different. They're totally different. The fact that you can see through this one makes it really an interesting effect. I could see making a really big one, like 200% size or 150% size in that thicker extrusion, and maybe it'd be a good display for a maker fair or something like that. So this is an interesting effect, totally different than anything else I've done. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below.